Hey guys, what's up?
Welcome to Playmat Format. Joker's back in it versus Emrakul. Emrakul got nothing on the burning of Black Lotus, just saying.
It's been a while since we played this format. We're actually playing Brawl tonight.
But I will let you know, not all of these cards are legal in my Brawl deck.
Same.
So it's actually an alternative Brawl, I think you should call it.
Yeah.
But it's still Brawl. A 60 card deck. I played Testoni Slesnia's Voice.
I'm sure he went with a lot of rambunctious combos, and I spent a good hour and a half building my deck or so. So I had a decent amount of time to build my deck.
I spent a half an hour to build this one, so we'll see how well it plays.
I got a Sir Farron, the Henge Hammer. That's how you say that, I'm pretty sure.
Pretty much cool legendary creature. I liked it when it came out in,
I think
what
it's
was this?
Throne of Eldraine. Yeah, I think it's a pretty decent uncommon legendary, honestly. Because
for a legendary, yeah.
For a legendary, for a two-drop legendary, I mean, sure, it's only a 2-2.
This is a two-drop, but the fact is, he could get his outfits.
Alright, so did I win the roll, or did you win the roll?
I lost.
Okay, so, playing a land for turn, I'll tap that one, and then I'll play a Rostorn Halberd. When it enters the battlefield, attach it to target non-human creature I control. I chose not to do that,
yeah.
So pass turn.
Pass turn. Let's just play this tapped and pass turn.
I'll untap. Draw.
I'll play my next land for turn. I'll tap two, and I will explore.
I'm going to, I may play an additional land this turn, and I get to draw a card. I got a land, so I'll play land.
Mm-hmm.
I have no place after that.
Okay. So, I'm guessing he's passing, so I'm going to untap.
Yep. If I say I have no place.
I'm going to play a Plains. I'm going to tap two and play an Intangible Virtue. Creature tokens you control get +1/+1 and have vigilance. That's what I think it is. It's a pretty cool commander card I got out of the Commander 2019 set.
You pass the turn?
And I pass the turn.
Alright. I'm going to untap. Draw. Reveal the top four cards in my library. I may put a creature card and or a land card among them into my hand. I obviously cut up the land and no creatures. Put the rest in my graveyard, which kind of sucks.
Ouch.
Yeah, I will play my land for turn.
Clover, ouch.
Pass turn.
Damn, he got Jude on that
situation.
Yeah,
I kind of did. I was
probably
should have
waited on that one. Anyways,
yeah, I'm not playing this right. I should have played my commander first, then played this.
Well, play a forest, then tap two to tap this, sacrifice it, and search my library for two basic land cards, put them on the battlefield. Great commander card. I don't know if it's legal in Brawl, but
well, if it's a commander card, then no. Because
well, you don't know that. It's just the land. It's not really a commander.
90% of the time, so yeah.
You don't know that until you actually look it up. But,
I don't
think
that.
And I will pass. Because that's all I may be able to do.
Brawl is not our best.
Yeah, I'm more of a commander guy.
I'm gonna go ahead and get a fucking creature.
What about you guys? Leave a comment down below. Let us know what do you guys like to play? Commander, Brawl. Yeah. Not many people like Brawl, so I don't even know why he said Brawl. Standard.
So I play my commander. Yeah. Sir Farron.
Popper.
When he attacks another target, attacking creature I control gets plus X, where X is his power. So, from there I will pass turn. You'll kind of see what I want.
As you can see my
equipment thing.
My lands. Draw. Then I will play Evolving Wilds. Crack Evolving Wilds.
Comes in tapped.
Yep.
Are you going to play your commander?
Yep.
Okay.
There would be no sense in leaving my board completely open.
Which will put your commander at a 6. That's not good for me.
No, he's not a token. So he won't get +1/+1.
It just says creatures you control. Oh, creature
tokens. Creature tokens you control. But I'm going to tap 4. Of course I'm going to play Testoni. Whenever another creature enters the battlefield under your control, you gain life equal to that creature's toughness.
That is a good
I can tap 1 green, 1 white, and populate.
Populate's good with that card.
So, blam, that's what I'm playing, guys.
Alright.
That's my commander, y'all. And, of course, Pester.
Alright. See what I can do. I'll play another land. I'm glad I went with Mono. I need to get some. Same turn it comes out, it's an artifact, and scry one. I will put that on the bottom because I do not need that yet. I will pass turn. Not really doing a whole lot right now.
I will untap, draw. Angel of Sanctions enters the battlefield. You may exile target anomaly and permanent and opponent controls until Angel of Sanctions leaves the battlefield. Target this.
Oh, you fucking prick.
And then I gain 3 life.
Took away my card value, man. I can't even fucking do it in response. I tapped on to fucking play it.
5 + 3 = 8. Okay. And then that is it.
Alright, now we'll untap my 5 lands. 5 with Monstrosity 4. I can pay 7 to make it a Monstrosity 4.
Make it an 8-9.
Yep.
With Reach. That is pretty damn good.
Yeah. Pass turn. For 5, yeah. It's not bad. That's why I was looking at it. I was like, oh, wow. And then 6, 7, 2 turns in, possibility of Monstrosity in it.
Exile this card from your graveyard, create a token that's a copy of it, except it's a white zombie angel with no mana cost. Blam, so.
Do you have an embalm card for that?
Copy it, and I will just exile this.
How do you do that?
When Angel of Sanctions enters the battlefield, you may exile target non-land permanent and opponent controls until Angel of Sanctions leaves the battlefield. And I gain 3 life. 3.
That's not good.
And a creature with power 3 or greater enters the battlefield, so I get to draw a card. Ow. And since it's a token, it's actually a 4/5 flyer.
There you go.
I knew all these ramp cards would come in handy.
I will tap 4 to play a weapon rack. Ooh,
weapon rack. Such a good card.
Enters with 3 1/1 counters on it. I will tap and put a 1/1 counter on my commander. Of course, making him a 3/3.
Gives
me 2 of those 4/5s, nice.
And gives me 2 4/5s. This is a 4/5 Angel of Sanction. So it entered the battlefield and I will exile it this until that leaves the battlefield. Yep. It says, when Angel of Sanction enters the battlefield, you may exile target non-land permanent and opponent controls. This had 2 counters on it.
We'll get it back. God. Wow.
Oblivion. I can tap it, draw a card, activate this ability only if you created a token this turn. I did. I created a token. This activates. I get to draw a card since it's a 4/5.
Almost none of these are standard.
I already said it wasn't standard legal deck, so. And actually, Angels of Sanctions actually is standard.
It's a commander fucking card.
Just because it's a commander card doesn't mean it's not a standard legal deck card. Just because it came out of a commander deck.
True.
They have a normal card of this. But I did play a token this turn, so I could tap that to draw a card.
You fucking stole my weapon back, you fucking asshole.
Yeah, and there's just no point in stealing your commander, or I would have done that. Well, not stealing it, but, you know.
Probably.
That tap thing. But we do it all the time, guys. We don't like to all the time. It gets annoying. But Angels of Sanctions there says it's your turn.
Go fuck yourself.
Create a token that's a copy of a creature token you control. That's what populate does. Now I have two of them, so I can just populate and gain one.
I will tap two. Dent in your phones. I'll use the rest of my mana to scry to you.
Did it start raining?
Yeah.
Oh, that's... Guys, it's raining in South Dakota. Oh, yeah, I forgot. You Washingtonians are still on lockdown. That sucks for you guys.
I cannot do anything else without killing my commander fast.
Don't worry, I want to make more Angel Sections. That get kind of boring.
Yeah, you gotta have other fucking tokens to make, right?
Yeah.
Actually, I want to check them out.
Untap that before I do anything.
But that's also a drawing mechanic.
That gives you a fucking 10-10 Eldrazi as well. God damn it.
Yeah.
I should have gotten that.
Play a land for turn. And I will swing at you with a 4-5 in the air.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh! And before I forget, I gain 10 life.
How do you gain 10 life?
8, 9, 10. Chastoni Celestia's voice. Whenever another creature enters the battlefield under your control, you gain life equal to the creature's toughness.
That's fucking bullshit. That's so good. I like that.
That's right. What I'm saying. That's what I built your brawl deck. That's why I was hoping you were going to play that one.
I didn't.
And then we would have went Celestia versus Celestia.
Yeah. Alright, is it my turn?
Yeah.
I was kind of wanting to build my own at the same time, but I forgot that you did that.
Yeah, that thing was broken as fuck. I was destroying you and Aaron with it. If only we were doing that for PAX, I would have been rich in PAX. That's what we should do one of these days, is do a tournament for PAX. And yeah, guys, give us info. Do you want to see a tournament for PAX? Let us know.
Yeah, man.
Our channel is only basically what we do is we literally play Magic,
make it a food token,
learn from our mistakes in Magic, and show off our decks to you guys. And every once in a while, we'll play a different game. And if you guys like our content, please leave a like.
Yeah. 1, 2, tap series launcher, spray one.
I like that wolf. This was one of my favorite things in a food deck. This wolf.
Yes.
I should have built a wolf deck at the pre-release. Not a wolf deck, but a food deck.
Oh, Pastor. Yeah, I got an army of flies.
Balas has trample and landfall. Whenever land enters the battlefield under your control, you may create a 4/4 green beast creature token.
Oh wow.
Yes. I got 3 minutes left. Damn, I needed one more dance.
I just realized something. Your 10-10. It's a token, isn't it?
It's a 10-10 token, yes.
It's an 11-11 token. With vigilance.
Huh. If he wouldn't have reminded me, it would have just been a 10-10
yes, token. But it's on the battlefield, so I feel it's fair. What's unfair is you still have my fucking weapon rack that has 2 fucking counters on it. What got rid of that?
What do you mean? I created another token of Angel of Ascension.
To get rid of that. To get my token back. To get my artifact back.
Well, I could just populate and create another one. Yeah.
Such a pain.
Yes. Literally, just get rid of my commander and you can hit everything. But at this point, I've I'll just win the game next turn. Pass.
Untap. Upkeep.
Bro. I ain't gonna lie. Green and white is broken, guys. I don't understand why. Until now. Until this commander deck came out. Primal Genesis. And that was last year's commander. I can't wait until I get my hands on some of them 2020 commander sets.
Tap three. Play this equip guy. That's it. Tap one. Make him 5/5. Let's go.
That's all it does is make him a 5/5.
Haste, yeah.
Alright.
It has to do with making him
hasty haste. Really, what is your command?
Whenever he attacks another target creature, he gets +X/+X, where X is his power.
Oh, that's cool.
Right?
But I don't think. I only have 11 left.
Or you're, yeah, you have that old drums.
With vigilance. So
leave
I can
that on
swing
top,
with
just
it.
Just in case.
I really thought that deck was going to be more fast paced.
Yours was pretty fast paced because you fucking had all those land drops.
Yeah, that was, that's because I had a whole handful of,
I have shit like
this,
that, too.
This, just, I had a whole handful of it. That's
I had
the only reason.
That I played right at the beginning of the game. I had this, Relentless Pursuit, and I have a couple other things like that.
Yeah. I had a whole handful of it, that's why I kept that hand of 3 mana, because, like,
it obviously wasn't a fucking drop.
This time, but when I was practice playing it, I never did get all that in one hand. Okay.
This takes a while to set up, I guess.
And this is where the game, I will play a land, gain a 4/4 beast token. Do I even have a 4/4? Yes. Gain a 4/4 beast token. Gain 4 life. And then I will tap this for green. 9 times.
What?
Populate 8 times. I tap 9 mana for it. I will.
Do you have 9 tokens? That's why it has double X. You can only populate as many tokens as you have. That's why it has double X.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. And I just gained a shit ton of life. So if you wanted to quit, that's on you.
No. No, let's go through the whole thing. 11, 12,
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 23, 24 life. Okay, those tokens can't attack yet, so I will just pass the turn.
Okay, one tap, a draw.
Guys are probably laughing at us like, wow, dude, you built a broken-ass commander-type fucking brawl deck, and he built an actual brawl deck.
Oh, as best as I could. I think there's a couple. I can't.
I'm pretty sure some of these cards are legal.
If it has the commander symbol, I'm pretty sure it's not.
It doesn't matter if it has a commander symbol or not. Just because it's in a commander deck doesn't mean it's
that's
not.
True. That's true. He stole my fucking engine, pretty much. Because that Seer's Lantern was a good part of my engine.
7, and I'll make it nearly impossible for you to deal damage to my creature tokens.
Prevent more damage that would be dealt to creature tokens you control. Not that that matters.
Yeah. Yeah, there's... Sorry guys, I don't know how long the video was.
It doesn't really say.
It's okay.
It does. 37 minutes.
Oh, okay. So this was a decent video. So I will just
swing on.
Swing everything but to study. So 2 11-11s with vigilance. 2 5-5s with vigilance. And 2 4-5s with vigilance.
Tap. 3 to wild size, making my 5-5 actually a 7-7. And drawing a card. I will block one of your 5-5s with my 7-7.
Prevent all damage that would be dealt to your creature tokens.
So I'll draw a card and reduce damage. One of your 11-11s, I'll block with a 2-2 death touch.
Okay.
It dies.
Prevent all damage that would be dealt to creature tokens you control. That means your death touch dealt.
Death touch specifically says any amount of damage. Oh yeah, any amount of damage. Zero is still
No, it's not. And if it prevents all damage, that means no damage goes through.
Oh, that's true. That's true. That is very true. Okay. So I blocked one of your 5/5s, one of your 11/11s. Right?
Yeah. I think you're still dead.
I have a 3/3 to block with. Hang on. I'll block another one of your 11/11s. No, I blocked two of your 11/11s, didn't I?
You only blocked one of the
I blocked your 11, other 11/11.
Okay.
So,
that's still. That's 8, 8, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, dude. You're still alive. Oh, wait. 21,
22, 3, 4, 5, 6, 27. Oh, you're so boring. No.
Well, it kind of sucks that there's only two people on the channel. If there was more people, I'm pretty sure I wouldn't have got all these tokens on the battlefield.
Yeah.
Technically, it's not a pre-built deck.
Did you put
Because I tore it apart.
Did you add any hearts? Also, did you add any hearts, though?
What?
It doesn't matter.
I added Wayfaring Temple.
You added that?
Yeah, I had it in my cards over there. Lightning Greaves from, Mystery Booster. So I added a couple of cards. So it wasn't complete pre-made.
But you didn't really play those cards.
Well, I couldn't play the cards. Oh.
This is also mine?
And so is that.
Unfortunately, this monstrosity actually
would have And I told you that was probably what I was going to do. Because I totally forgot about Brawl Night, because we never play Brawl Night.
Yeah,
so.
I thought it would be nice to play a Brawl game.
I did bring a couple of already made decks, but I already played them on channel.
Yeah. Hopefully we can get two new decks tomorrow
on the channel.
Tomorrow is Commander Night, isn't it?
Commander, yes. I built a new deck for
I'm gonna have to go ahead and find myself a commander to build and build that. I'm definitely gonna build this guy again. he wouldn't be so bad if it was against multiple people. I probably, if I would have had more time to wait. I have such good green cards.
When Jack is over, we usually do have at least a third person in the battle. We need to find our own play group.
We definitely do.
Other than that, it's just me and him doing this channel. If you want to join us, let us know one of these days. If we're in Washington and we're doing a video, let us know, guys.
Yeah.
We'll show up and let you guys join us on Playmat Format. Other than that, right now, Playmat Format's over. Remember to like, subscribe, leave a comment. Hit the notification button so you guys know our next
time we post a video or anything.
Or anything. Also, we do have a group on Facebook if you want to learn what we're going to play or what we're giving away on Patreon. I just posted that.
Or what we're selling for that matter.
Or what we're selling, because soon we will be actually selling cards, not just to Card Kingdom, but to people that actually want good cards. We had this one guy asking Ascend Triplets. It's like, even if it was from Mystery Booster, TCG player still said it was around $18.55.
And with that and all the other cards, he wanted
and
to buy it.
A foil Euro.
He wanted to buy it for $40. All of them for $40. And,
50?
50. Even so.
$50?
All of it. When it all adds up to over $200.
We told him we'll sell him single cards that he wanted, but, you know, he didn't message back. We do not have those cards anymore, but when we do have a stack of cards, we will let you guys know. Other than that, the other way to support the channel is go to About Me, and down below will be a link to our Patreon.
In the About Me, yes.
If you go to the group, you'll understand what we're giving away for Patreons. We are getting more packs for Patreons, just in case we do get Patreons.
Yep.
And eventually, we will do a live show with donations.
Yes.
And you guys can talk to us. Find out what we're actually doing. We don't exactly know what we're doing on this channel. Literally, what we've been doing is sometimes we'll do a bit of news, sometimes we'll just play and have fun, sometimes we'll fight and still have fun.
Yeah. And then the main thing that we always look forward to, and it seems that's the main thing you guys always look forward to, is our openings.
Yes, when we have a box, we get so excited, and that's the most views we get, is on the openings of the boxes, apparently. Sometimes, there was one we did get 19 views on, which was Renata versus my Wolf deck. Yeah. Everybody loved that one. It was off the hook.
I think that's partially because I got off to a really good start, and then you just kind of swooped in with all those wolves, and I was like, well, there's nothing more I can do.
The wolf token mechanic is broken on that War of the Spark frickin' card.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie. Fucking play a wolf, it attacks a creature on your opponent's side of the field, it automatically gets a +1/+1 counter.
My Renata did not stand a chance because
and
of how her toughness was.
Her toughness stayed 3.
Yeah,
not toughness, but the second number.
Toughness.
This one right here always
tough.
Stayed a 3, unless he could get a +1/+1 counter on it.
Which I really, if I do go and I should take some of these cards and put it in.
Yeah, that was a good deck. I'm not going to lie.
You just had a better deck.
I just didn't have anything to build, so that's what I brought. It was actually a commander deck that I just took apart.
Yeah. All right, guys.
But thank you. And please check out our Patreon. Pretty soon, like Joe said, we'll have a donation button on our page, too, on Facebook. So you can donate to us on Facebook. And donations from there will also get you a playmat. And if you donate enough, we'll get you a booster box, open it on the channel, and we'll send it straight to you.
Yeah.
But that's up to you guys. So, I guess right now, have a good night. We'll see you tomorrow with Commander.
Yeah.